a really cool integration that exists between HubSpot and Outlook or Gmail, depending on which email system you're using, is the inbox automation, as you can see here. So once you've set up your email and you've connected it up here, which I'll cover in a different video, so check that out, then you can turn on, in the process, you can actually turn on this inbox automation. So when you're connecting the email, you get this little tick box here. So you tick that, turn it on, and then you can connect up your inbox, and it should appear like this, like it's been turned on, switched on. And what happens when this is switched on, when you send emails, or sorry, when you receive email from a contact, so let's say you've sent out a proposal or a lead, a lead generation email, and you get an email reply, HubSpot will automatically scan that email reply and pull in the information from that email into your HubSpot system for that contact. So for example, it'll get the first name, last name, the details that are inside the email signature of the contact. So for example, job title, company name, perhaps the phone number, etc. And it can also, and pull in the address of the company as well. So any details that are in the signature, it'll also scan the email content. And if it sees a phone number there, it'll pull that in as well. So it's incredibly useful functionality. And I would say it's definitely worth switching on. And you can also control under the contact settings, you can see here, when you go down to this section, contacts, under the objects data management section, you can control whether it's going to fill in the details from the emails from the HubSpot AI. This is called the HubSpot AI. There's a lot of different AI things going around at the moment. So this one is relating just to the inbox automation. So you can see it's pulling in details here. As you can see, if this is ticked, it'll update records in HubSpot with details from the email signature, etc. So you need to make sure this is ticked. It should be automatically switched on, but you can always double check that under objects. And then you turn that, that's for your whole account. And then this is just for your individual access. This needs to be switched on per user in HubSpot as well. So this is not going to be account level. As you can see here, this is just for preferences, just for you as the individual person accessing the HubSpot account. So let's have a look at it in action. So essentially, I've got an email here that I've just put together. I'm sending it to this Outlook inbox so that I can show you an example. I've just populated this with some random content here. Hello, Thomas. Hope this finds you well. Are you available for a quick call, etc. Okay, so I send this out. And then I go to my fake email account here. Let's refresh this. This is in my little Outlook account, and then after a couple of minutes, this should come through, and it's going to show the email that I've just sent myself. So let me just play with this for a second. And then what I'm going to show you is in HubSpot, how it appears in HubSpot when this information is coming through. Okay, here's the email that's come through. So we can see this, the one I just sent. And so let's say I reply to this email, or imagine that I'm a client receiving this email. You've sent this email out. Hope this email finds you well. Introduce you to HubSpot, blah, blah. So it can be, whatever content you're sending your prospects. We can reply here. See, it's added the subject. It's added my fake signature here as well. So I'm going to say, thanks, Tristan. And I'm going to say, feel free to call. Call me on. And then I'll just put my phone number in here. This is a fake number. 9500. Okay. And then I can just say, thanks on my mobile. Let's really test this out. I'll say my mobile. I'm going to change this. I'm going to add another mobile number. I'm going to say 0411. 0404 0404, or my office might be like this. It might just be like simple like this. Get rid of all that. Okay. Like so. Let's see how this comes through. I'm actually not sure how this will pull in, so let's try that out. There we go. So I'm pretending that I'm the client now sending this, or the prospect. We send that out. And now we can go back to our inbox and we can see how that email looks. So here's the email that's come through, my reply. So this is my fake account reply, and we can open up the HubSpot integration and see the email contact here. So let's have a look at the what's saved in the CRM. So we can see name. Let's look at view property history. You can see a few things have been updated. Here we go. Postal code, HubSpot AI, mobile phone number, HubSpot AI. Let's go in to the view all properties. And we can see, so let's have a look at phone numbers. So, okay, interesting. So it hasn't pulled in the regular phone number, but it has pulled in the mobile phone number. Very cool. We can see when we click on, when we hover over, we can see the details and we can see it's come through from HubSpot AI. Let's look at address. There we go. The address has been pulled in and we can look at, let's see if job title. No, job title wasn't pulled in. Interesting, interesting. So this is going to only bring in the some of the information, depending on how the AI works. It hasn't pulled in this detail for some reason. And it's pulled in this first number, but it hasn't pulled in the second number. Maybe it's not clear. It has managed to get the address, which is great. So that's interesting. And it's pulled in the name from here. From here for the email rather than the name in here, but that's okay. What's important to keep in mind is that this will only work for the first reply that comes in. So when you're sending your email out to the client, to the prospect, and they reply, that's the only email that will be scanned by the AI and pulled in with the details pulled into HubSpot. So let's say I reply to this email again to this prospect, and then he replies to my email with some additional information. That information won't go in to HubSpot anymore. So it's just a one-off kind of thing. It's not supposed to replace your process for, you know, adding details about a contact. It's really just to support and to help, you know, to make things just a little bit faster and easier for you. So I think that that's pretty useful and it's a great feature to keep in mind. The other thing you can do as well, once you've used this a few times, is you'll be able to export all the field properties into a spreadsheet or from a spreadsheet from HubSpot as well. If you go to the contacts section under the objects, like this data management objects contacts, then scroll down, you can go here and you can export the field properties. So that's it. I think this is a really powerful feature. Please check it out, give it a shot. And if you have any issues with it, then let me know if you have any questions or if you have any feedback or thoughts about this feature. I think it's very powerful. I think it's worth turning on and then, you know, making the most of it so that you can extract more details from your emails and your inbox and get the details into HubSpot nice and easy. So let me know what you think and look forward to seeing you in the next video. Cheers. Bye.